Jesus! An issue made from different types of milk. But this is Russian cheese. It's only cottage inside. You get cheese or starvation. That is the options you get in supermarket. So what type of cheese are you using in my videos? It is just one kind. And today, we make some. Yes, Boris! Блин. So this block of Slavic goodness, it only cost a fraction more than the amount of milk that goes inside. But with the amount of cheese I eat, it really start paying off in couple of days. Russian cheese is strong. And I mean strong enough to build a house. You ever run out of bricks or beton? You whip out your cheese making skills you learned from Boris. You can place long, big shit, you can build a whole Russian railway system with this cheese. Look, this soft is a bin. Crumble like Western economy. What you going to build with this? It's only rotting inside. I'm not even going to mention this, this is just... Oh, it is sweet!
How did we get so long?
No, not trust this clan. Trust the building block. But just like, let me show you. Stick a pot will hold all your cheesy ambition. On average, 1 liter of milk will make about 100 grams of cheese. Grab some Chernobyl rainwater to keep you going. Давай. Но DC the best milk come from Happy Cow. Вообще, how am I supposed to know what she was feeling? Was she having a bad day? It does not see the package. I mean, best you can do is walk out of the store happy. Or put the milk if you're happy. Just walking around laughing in the store. Or you can pour the milk where you're laughing. Твою мать. Now do keep in mind this cheese does take about 3 hours to make. 4 whole weeks of additional waiting time. And up to 2 years if you want it harder. And not at all the spicy left from the audience. And only 3 just remain. Let's start building that cornerstone of Soviet economy. Next up you want to introduce the Hutch. This Brovin from Poland. You do not want too much hutch inside. You not want to start peeling theaters in the cheese. Take a thermometer, yes, you will need it. Unless you're very good at measuring 33 degrees Celsius with your hand. It is exactly the temperature we want. Okay, the milk is warm, we need to introduce the culture. Now we want to add but exactly yes, this much. For every 3 liters of milk you will need this much. Focus, сука! Come on, урод! Shit, бабушка, it's better out of focus than this junk. Ah, good. Compared to teaspoon, this is bad. That much? I mean, it's not exactly a whole teaspoon, maybe half, maybe a quarter of teaspoon. It's like the camera is trying to make me angry. I will not sell you to Happy New Honor. You're going into meat grinder. So sprinkle the culture into the milk soup, take out your pre-eliminator, and push the culture very slowly from top to bottom, very lightly. You're trying to wake it up. From very long sleep. You see, cheese culture is much better than regular culture. Because regular culture, you cannot eat. I forgot where I was going with this. Well, set your phone timer to 30 minutes. Take this time to call your cousin. What? Were you in the army again? Did you finish already? Come on, we have videos to make. Cover it up so Artem does not eat the premature cheese. Now that we have introduced culture to the world, let's start. With chemistry lesson.
But Boris, weren't you making cheese?
This is cheese making silence in the back. It's a calcium chloride. We need just about 2 grams for each 10 liter of milk. Which translates to exactly this much. And this is why we need to live higher than first floor. Forget the neighbors, it's the street people that start calling the police. We put it in a bit of water so it dissolves easier. I do like making cheese. Mix around just a bit. And this part we like to call the cottage cheese phase. Because it turned the milk into small bits of what the f***. Hey Panasonic, if you not can make camera, then stop making camera. Go back to making lamp sockets, there is no shame. So this is basically the ferment. It is called René. It comes in liquid, in tablets, in pills, in whatever form you can find. And 15. This one requests 5 drops. For every liter of milk. Now it is highly suggested you put it into water first because it could be harder to dissolve in big pot. And if not mix well enough, you get big пиздец. And very slowly, you mix for about 1 minute, not more. Very soon you will see why. Leave it wait for about 45 minutes. Definitely covered, you not want flies or vadim to accidentally drop inside. Sometimes I wish that Erhun would sponsor these videos. But you only sell it in Russia, so okay, 45 minutes has passed, and it is time to tell you a sad story. And the story goes like this. Not all milk is suitable for making cheese. Again. So basically, the best type of milk is raw milk. The stuff you get from straight from under the cow. But we not have raw milk. We have store-bought
pasteurized, but even with that, we can make a nice thick soup.
Oh, look at that.
So if you not have this result, maybe wait 5-10 minutes more, but if still nothing, soup wrap, try again, and get the right type of milk. Maybe you accidentally bought ultra pasteurized milk. That is basically boiled milk. You cannot use that. Now check out your bayonet knife and start slicing the milk. Basically you want to make 2 cm blocks and that will become the curds of the cheese. Look at that nice thick soup. Hey, focus on the thing. What? Bet? No. You see, this way we cannot have nice things. This way we need sponsors in videos. For Boris to find the perfect camera to record something as complex as making cheese at home. Also make some small diagonal slices. This will make them break up in other direction as well.
Nice.
Now start shuffling around the soup that you have made. If you have the right type of milk and the correct amount of components inside, then this block should be forming into small, I would say, baked bean sized pieces. Mix it around gently for about 5 minutes. If after the 5 minutes of shuffling, the pieces all look like very small bits of rice or ground meat, then you have the wrong milk, start again. Now the milk that I can find in local corner store is basically the minimum for making cheese. It's not the best quality. But if you think to use high quality milk to make the tin to factory, ha! Welcome to world of comedy, my friend! Let them make shit for about 5 minutes. This will allow the cheese to drop to bottom. Now remove some water, about 1/3 of the whole thing, and shuffle it around just a bit. As you can see, there is some small, some bigger pieces inside. This is what I like to call the bare minimum for making cheese, and also the most realistic method because this is what you usually find in store. So please, yes, do try this at home. Heat up some water in another pot to 55 degrees. Put the warm water into the mix to same level as you had before. The mix should not be at 38 degrees. If it's too hot, add cold water instead. Fun fact, 38 degrees is the body temperature of a cow. Do not ask how I know. This process reduces acidity of the cheese. You do not want a taste of Chernobyl. Repeat this step, remove the water from the mix and replace with warm water instead. Mix for another 5 minutes and now should be about consistency of cottage cheese. Yes, that is how it is made. If you squeeze like this, it should stick together like that.
Nice.
It's basically ready. Take cheesecloth and colander, rather bigger one than small, pour in the cheese slowly. You need some type of cheese form. This special one we hold in bottom. Put in the cheese with a cloth. Place some pressure on top, about 5 kg at first. Maybe vodka, 5 kg of meat, slapping hot lime. Me, I have special one, but it's hard to find. Now you let it sit under 5 kg for about 20 minutes. Take this time to clean up your kitchen. No, you're not going to. Not know what uses, wait, I show you. You can use Svetlana, she not mine. Maybe whole case of Tatra tea. Yummy's face mask at the bottom. Happy birthday, by the way. Or just use the blocks of money that you save by making your own cheese at home. This is actually not real money. You can buy this at store here. After 20 minutes, you remove the cheese from the mold, flip it over and put it back under 10 kilograms this time for 6 hours. Yes, you heard correct. Once the 6 hours is done, it is time to add the salt. Extract this edge from the mold. You will need 1 egg, some water and some salt. Get some salt inside, mix it around, put egg inside. If it drops to bottom, it's not salty enough.
Опа!
Put some calcium chloride inside if you still have some. This allows the cheese to be more hard on the outside. Oh, nice. We start the salting process. We need 6 hours on one side and 6 hours on the other side. Put something on top so you go completely in the water. And now we wait for 12 hours. Nice. Now it has set in the water for 12 hours. Set it to dry on surface, something with holes in the bottom so the moisture can escape. If not, have no problem. Just let it set on cutting board. Just do not forget to flip it once every day. And in total, you have to let it dry for about 3 days. Ideally, the temperature should be around like 15 degrees, but 20 is fine. Definitely not above 25. By far, my favorite part of cheese making
is the wax.
Obviously, we choose Boris yellow, so it matches with, you know, other things in the wardrobe. Yes, it's close enough. если you do need special cheese wax, not floor wax. Now I dip the cheese inside, just like that. Don't worry about putting it down and dry very fast. Other side as well, and now the edges. Oh, it's beautiful. You can put two layers if you want. I do. I like it. Once you have the wax set, you can wax other things you like. This Adidas play button, this empty bottle of vodka to commemorate our lost comrades. You know, the options are endless. Now, the wax is very nice and hot on the outside, which means the cheese can do its business on the inside. Place it on dry surface like this, give the official Boris Гопникова seal of approval. Put small signs of Vadim not eat it. And now, we wait for 20 days. Давай, cheers, comrades. There's not much else you can do. Maybe write down when you made the cheese, you know, put up security cameras, the usual. But overall, that's it. I will be sure to post on Instagram or something where I make booty bro with this cheese eventually. But until then, what else can I say? Thank you for watching, stay cheeky-breaky, and I will see you next time.